a member of an elite drone unit here in Ukraine, showed us up close just how drones are so unbelievably effective here at taking out Russian targets. How are they doing it? Where are they doing it? And now the unit is getting a major boost, and they're getting that boost from young Ukrainian video game lovers.
We use this strategy of 10 days of intelligence, like making map of
positions. Which is you doing the drones.
Yeah, and we have a group of 8 people. I was the guy who flying. We have a commander and a guy who actually my security team. They was in the bushes just watching so I wouldn't be killed.
While you're controlling the drone.
Yeah.
So you're flying the drone.
Yeah.
They're sort of backing you up.
Yeah, exactly.
And you do that for 10 days.
Yeah, every
day. And then you map out.
Yep, exactly. After that, we have this map.
This is Vlad Demchenko's map of Novibikov, the town we're standing in. He made it using his drone. You can see he circled target after target after target in red. Here's what happens after that.
We invite a serious drone, like those ones that can stay in air for 2 hours. Mm-hmm. And I was sent it with them. So I was pointing them like where they need to fly. And they have a connection with artillery. And we was like working on each target. Like,
okay.
So we put our priorities and step by step. And you just like, next. And it's fun, kind of fun, to be honest.
Yes.
We're standing at the site of Vlad's first big strike. How many of them were there?
I think around 20, 30 people.
20 or 30?
Yeah. And at least 10 of them was killed here.
The drones are helping kill so many Russians that in another village, shown here by a CNN drone, a man told me Russian soldiers occupying his house were given bonuses of cigarette cartons to shoot down Ukrainian drones.
We are using Chinese drones, and Chinese give Russians programs that can search us, spot it out. So Russians see from where we're starting and where we're landing. And once it happened to us that it was attacked like right away. The drone was landing, and the next, like in 30 seconds, the landmine was just like, it was really close, like 30 meters away.
Cool. It was a moment, Vlad says, much like this one.
They see the whole road from where I fly up, where I landing, everything.
Right.
They see everything. They see my phone.
A Chinese company makes both the DJI drone that Vlad uses and a software program, Aeroscope, that tracks much of what the drone does. That's what Vlad says the Russians are using to combat Ukraine's drone warfare. How were you able to do the drone then for all those 10 days and get all the information
now,
without them knowing?
Now we have a whole strategy. So you're coming first, you don't turn the drone on, like you're walking away from your group like a couple hundred meters, you're leaving the drone, you turn it on, you're coming back away from the drone, you're starting your pull, and you're flying really, really low, like 10 meters, and only next to their position, you're going up, making a search, like making the pictures, making a video, and coming back like in very, very different directions, so they can't track you in a straight way. By now, I personally know 3 guys being killed. Just because nobody know how to work with that before, and this is the price we pay for have this tactic now.
Vlad says there is an American drone the Russians can't track. He wants a lot more of those.
Imagine like you're having your infantry and there is like a live guys, they need to go into the village. Imagine how easier if there is a drone in front of them and telling them, hey guys, there is a tank, there is a vehicle, there is a group of enemy on the left, they just prepared. Now in each platoon we have a guy with a drone.
Wow.
It's funny to say, but most of these drone guys is just young nerds who used to play video games.
Right, and now now the skill is
It's cool
applicable.
Skill. And you know what, mostly like, of course, if they are just youngest guy, like 18 years old, nobody will send them like to liberate the villages. But they can do their job sitting from like 5 kilometers away, just like, it's kind of fun for them.
Yeah. Now Deputy Commander Demchenko has moved up the ranks fast. Proof taking risk and being nimble is rewarded here.
The commander asked, like, did you know how to fly drone? I said, yes, definitely, of course. And when they give me actual drone, I was like, just take it on the place we was living and try it like...
You were just on your own practicing.
Yeah, I don't say anybody that I did it only once in my life, but you just, I don't know.
You learned on the fly.
Yeah.
Wow.
I think it's like the main thing is pretty easy. The main thing in this is just to stay calm.
An incredible story, and those drones are just so front and center in absolutely everything here. I want to add that what that villager told me, you know, about the Russians getting the cartons of cigarettes for shooting down the drones, he said the Russians would sit there in the garden and try to shoot down drones, and it was really hard because they're so tiny, and they really were very rarely even able to shoot them down. It's just an incredible development in this story.